Hello all. My name is Benny. I'm from Israel. I'm a researcher in the Agriculture Research Institute. This is a photo of my institute. It's like a university. We have many faculties, and we deal with agriculture problems in Israel. We research to save problems in the agriculture field. Israel is a very non-friendly country for agriculture. We don't have rain. We have too little rain. We have a desert in the south part of Israel, meaning that we don't have water, we don't have good land for agriculture, we don't have a lot of work power for agriculture, and still with all this, we have also other problems like geopolitical problems. We don't have the distance between Israel and Europe. It took me 2 hours flight to get here, and we export most of our things to Europe. So we have many problems, and with all these problems, we find solution. We have a very successful agriculture, and we try to export all our products abroad. How do we do that? This is a picture of many greenhouses in Israel at the end of the season when we want to see the results. Those are the results that we want to see at the end of the season. Those are the things that we are willing to see to sell abroad. We have an extreme hard program of innovation, research and development, connected with extension. We bring our solution to the agriculture in the field. We bring the problems of the agriculture to the research. We have good practice. We teach them how to work, how to do, how to use all the developments that we did. And also we have many companies. Israel has a lot of agriculture companies, new tech companies, that they export their products abroad. So we are a global leader in agro technologies and water systems. Of course, since we don't have water, we have a lot of R&D and know-how, and we invest a lot of money in research. Just to know, Israel invests nowadays something around 4.3 of the national budget in research. That's one of the highest in the world just for research. So you can see all the companies in Israel, small companies that they show up in the last 5-10 years to work in the farm. You can see a farm here, and we have companies that they develop products for the different parts of the company, for cows, for the field, for to treat water and everything else. So I'll give some examples here. I start with the example of the water. The irrigation system in Israel is very well known. We use drip irrigation to save water. Moreover, we have the water is a critical thing in Israel. Israel is the only country in the world that all the wastewater from the cities are collected. I'm sorry, 90% is collected, and 90% goes back to agriculture as irrigation water. So we are the only country in the world that does that. It means something around 80% of the wastewater is used for irrigation. All kinds of irrigation? Of course not. We cannot use treated wastewater for tomatoes, but we can use for cotton, we can use for orange, and we do that. As I said, we have the drip irrigation to save water. The amount of water is calculated, so the plant will be happy with enough water to grow. We have problems of different levels, so we have to keep the pressure constant. So a lot of technologies involved in drip irrigation. Drip irrigation is not just a pipe with a hole in the pipe. There is a lot of technology inside of it. So all this is used for to save water and to have the maximum amount of plants per square meter. So we use marginal waters, we use in Israel saline water from groundwater, we use wastewater treated, we have desalination technologies. Most of the desalination technologies used around the world were developed in Israel, and we sell abroad, and nowadays the main target in Israel is that in another 10 years, all the population are gonna drink desalinated water. We have the water authority in Israel. I'm sorry for the political that are here, but sometimes they're problematic because one party is in power, they decide to do this. Another power is in power, they decide to do that. And water is critical. Agriculture is critical. It cannot change the mind every time a different party is in power. We have to have a committee that has plans, short plans, medium plans, long-term plans, and they don't change with political parties. And that's the same thing for water in Israel. We know what's the plan for another 10 years for the water. They know where they need water nowadays. They know how much water they need to supply to each city. So we have a lot of water saving process. In cities different than other parts of the world, we have around 6% of the water is missed on the way for the people, because we have to save water. We have also other aspects, high technology. We have breeding. As we heard before, we need plants with something else that can give a higher price in the market. Vitamins, antioxidants. As we know, the cherry tomato was invented in Israel, but that's not good enough anymore. We need tomatoes with different colors. We need cherry tomatoes with different shapes. We need tomatoes that we can grow in the desert. We need tomatoes that we don't need so much water. So we're always looking for the next thing. Also, hydroponic to save from diseases. You can see a hydroponic greenhouse in Israel for lettuces. To save water, we use precision agriculture. You can see here, the land looks the same, but this part was over-irrigated and this part was regularly irrigated. Using a camera, photos, we can determine how much water was given to the plant. Was that enough? Was not enough. Fertilizer, we can calculate using photos to see if the plants are getting enough nitrogen. We can even see nowadays diseases. We can see diseases in the plants. We use technology. We have to improve the pictures. We use drones to take pictures on the field and to see what we have in the field. After we grow the plants in the field, we have to bring them here to Europe. It's a long way. We don't bring them by plane. So we have to put them in bags. Those bags were especially developed to promote changes of gases. Gases that promote the plants to grow fast or to reap fast, they come out from the bags. And gases that are good for the fruits, they get into the bag to keep the fruit fresh. Those are kinds of herbs that are planted in Israel. Not so much to stay in Israel, but to come to Europe. Israel is responsible for 50% of all the herbs used in Europe, and we are 2 hours flight far from here. Look that the plants need to be like clones. They need to be exactly the same. They have to be exactly the same amount of leaves, because the Germany, France, England, they are very strictly about that. When they want to buy one thing, they want all to be the same. If you start to produce plants that each plant is different, they don't want to buy that. So you have to use plants that they produce plants that they are exactly the same, plant them, and bring them to Europe. Also, nowadays, in Europe, in Israel, in the United States, we cannot use so much chemical. We have diseases in the plants, and we have to control these diseases, use green products. Like here, we use only mint oil to prevent the growth of the plant, so we can bring them to Europe to sell here. This plant here, this fruit here, has a lower price than this one. No one wants to buy this in the supermarket. Also, orange, they develop a yeast on the fruit that no one wants to buy. The taste changes a little bit. Is it dangerous for people? No, but we won't sell it anymore. So you have to prevent this kind of disease in a green way, using products that won't affect the human being. Also, in Israel, we have wheat. We need wheat to eat, to produce bread. And we don't produce enough wheat in Israel. We have to import from Russia. We have to import from Europe. And we have to keep them. Also here in Europe, when you produce wheat, sometimes the agriculture that he wants to produce but doesn't want to sell now because the price is too low. He wants to sell in another 2-3 months. So he has to keep this wheat and not get spoiled, not to get disease, and keep it safe. In Israel, we use lots of technologies, lots of gases to prevent diseases. And our waste is around 0.5%. This wheat is kept for 2-3 months, and we lose only 0.5% of it. It's the lowest in the world. We use technologies to see if there is any insects inside. We use pheromones to prevent insects to get in or to get out if they are in. We use a lot of green technology to prevent these insects to eat our wheat. The cow. In Israel, the cow is not so big and not so beautiful like in the U.S. We want the cow to produce milk and not to be beautiful, I'm sorry. It's an industry, more or less, to produce milk. So in Israel, we use milking machinery, and we also develop lots of products to check the milk quality online for those that produce milk. Milk with high fat content has a higher price, low fat content, lower price, so we can check the fat content in the milk and put that milk apart because it can have a higher price and agriculture can have more, can get more money. The cow in Israel walks with 5 tags all day long. These tags help the producer to check, is the cow eating enough? Is the cow walking enough? Is the cow resting enough? The cow is a milk producer, so we need to know when the cow needs to give birth. So these tags, they help, because when the cow walks, starts to walk a lot, means that the cow wants to give birth. So we know exactly when the cow needs to give birth. That's to save money, because when the veterinary comes to help the cow, we need to pay him per hour. If he comes, does his job, and go home, we pay only 1 or 2 hours. We don't pay for 5 hours work. We want to see how much the cow is resting. If the cow is resting, more of the food is becoming milk. If the cow is walking too much, maybe the cow is getting sick. Nowadays also, we need to know if the cow is suffering. We want to produce milk, eggs, and everything else, and the animal cannot suffer. We can check with these tags if the cow is starting to suffer. Unfortunately, cow, chicks, they don't know how to talk. If they feel a little pain, they don't tell us. But with these tags, we can see that the chick or the cow is starting to feel some pain, and we can prevent the disease before the disease becomes too big and we need to give some antibiotics to the cow. So we have to, nowadays, we work in the Vulcan Institute in a lot of fields. We have a huge rise in demand for food. As said before, we need to to produce more food in less land with less water. We have, as I said, less land for farming. We have less water for farming. And we need to continue giving more food for everybody in the world. So we need to have more with less money inside. We have to have more income for the farmer. The question that someone asked me, I don't remember who asked me before, is what's going to be in the future? We also work for the future. In the beginning, in the 70s, we want to to produce a lot to feed everybody in the world, to feed everybody in Israel. In the 80s, the shelf life was important, not just the quantity. In the 90s, the shape, the texture, the flavor of the fruit. In the 2000, health, the quality of the food. The 1 million euro, or not 1 million anymore, 1 trillion euro question is, what's going to be the future? Where we are going to make money, a lot of money in the agriculture in 2030? We, of course, I don't have all the answers, and if I had all the answers, I would be millionaire. But we think that personalization of food would be one of the ways. You know, everybody here is different. We have different DNA. Sometimes I eat a grape that doesn't make me good and make good to someone else. So we know according to my DNA, and the plant in the supermarket comes with a DNA tag. I can see and check. This grape is not gonna be good for my stomach, I will feel not good for my blood, health food, food that's not just gonna have some vitamins, but it's gonna prevent us to have diseases, organic food, that's the way the world is going. We need to prevent, to not use anymore any chemicals in the soil. It's getting into the plants, it's getting our body, it's getting to the soil, it's getting to the groundwater and contaminate our environment. Flavor, color, shape. Unfortunately, us human beings, we eat before with our eyes than we eat with our mouth. So people buy food that they are beautiful, that they are very green, that they are bright. So we need to produce those foods for people to buy them. And innovation, self-growing. In Israel, we're very proud of our agriculture. Similar to Greece, our farms are small, mostly family farms. We have some exceptions, but they work together. Most of the farmers, they try to work together to know what the neighbors are growing. They buy equipment together so they can save money. We know that agriculture, that like most of the things in the world, unfortunately nowadays, is money. We cannot stay growing something that's nice, beautiful, but doesn't bring an income to the farmer. The farmer in Israel knows that if this year I didn't have a good income with this product, next year I'm gonna plant something else. Of course, technology is also involved in that. In the Vulcan Institute, you try to develop programs that the farmer can come and say, look, I have this kind of soil, I have this amount of land, I have this amount of rain, I can use this amount of water. And we can use, you know, in the market today, there is the future market that you know the price, more or less, you know the price, what's the future for banana, for avocado. And you can tell the farmer and help him, look, I think that the best for you is to plant avocado this year. So we try to use all the technology available to help the farmer to improve his income. They gave me only 15 minutes. Thank you.